Hello everyone, myself Fatima. I hope you all are doing well. In today's lecture, we'll see if, if else, nested if and elif statement. So basically, statement belongs to this four category. First one is if statement. This execute only when the given condition is true. For false condition, no such statement execute if you are using only if statement. Now further proceed, second statement, which is if else, it is execute when condition is true as well as false. So when condition is true, if portion will execute, and if the condition is false, then else portion will be execute. Nested if, third category, it is also execute for both true as well as false condition scenario. Then last one is elif. Elif means ladder if else, you can say, but in Python they are using the word elif, so it is also execute for both true and false scenario. So let us start with if statement. So this is the syntax for if statement in Python. Now before going to this particular statement, there is one concept which is known as indentation. So indentation is nothing but the space. Here in Python, no bracket concept is allowed, while in another language like C language or Java or PHP, we have one opening curly bracket and closing curly bracket that will decide that yes, this particular block belongs to this statement. But in Python, there is no such concept available. It will use the concept of indentation, which is space. So how you can do that, that I will show you in this session. So first of all, write down if keyword, then give a condition. What condition can be anything. Then here you need to give colon. After that, give enter and leave some space. So that space here, my cursor is moving. So this is known as indentation. Okay, and start writing your code, and whatever, how many lines you want to write, just make sure it will be only in single indentation, otherwise it will generate error. And if you want to go outside from that block, just end it like this, or you can simply write print statement and end, which will indicate yes, the block of if statement is ending here. So let us go on practical session. So here, take new file, if statement. So first write down if, then condition. But before that, suppose I am giving two variable value, a is equal to integer, input, integer, input, and then enter first number. Okay, why I have used this input and integer function? Because input is used to take input from user, which I have already explained in detail how it will work. So check out the previous video for this input function or how you can take input from user. Second number. Okay, so now basically we'll check if the number first, which is given by user, is maximum or greater than the second one or not. So here I can write like this, if A is greater than B. So this A is greater than B represent my condition. Then give a colon, then enter. When you enter, by default the cursor will leave some space and here it will indicate. So you can start writing here like this, print A is greater than B. You can write like this, if the condition is true, this statement will be executed. But what if the condition is false? So for false condition, nothing is there if you are using only if statement. So that is the drawback of only if. So that's why we are using if else to overcome this situation. Now, save this program. So, this is our practical number 5. Just overwrite this one, or you can give any name to this practical. Then run module. Now give any number. Suppose I have given 34, then second number 56. So here you can see what happened here. Because I have given only for true condition the statement, so for false condition no statement is available, so that's why nothing will be printed, just the loop is terminated or it is not entering in that particular statement. Here you can see enter the first number, second number. Here obviously 34 is greater than 56, no, so that's why this statement A is greater than B will not be executed. Either it will directly go here and print the ending statement. Again run the module. Now for first number, suppose I have given 43, for second number I have given 23. So now the condition is satisfied, that's why it will print A is greater than B. Okay, so this is how simple if statement work. Now next is if else. So what you can do here, in if statement you just include one block which is else, and whatever statement you want to write here for false condition you can write here. So the syntax will be like this: if keyword, then give a condition, then colon, then give indentation, indent, then some code you want to write, after that else condition which represent the false statement, whatever statement that is not true in this condition, that kind of statement you can write here. So same practical here, just add one block else, give a colon, then whenever you enter, by default the cursor will leave some space and you can start writing here. Here in first statement I have written A is greater than B, so here it will exit opposite of that, so B is greater than A. Complete it, and now your if else is done. So what is the difference between simple if and if else? Simple if statement execute only when the condition is true, but if else is execute for both, condition is true as well as condition is false. If condition is false, else part will be executed. If condition is true, if part will be executed. Now run this program. Here give a number, suppose I have given 45, then here 78. So here you can see B is greater than A, means 78 is greater than A. So for false condition also this statement is executed. So this is about if else. Now next is nested if. So in nested if, you need to learn the concept about inner block and outer block. So here you can see this, if then give condition then colon. Inside this if block you can again write if else or simple if statement, whatever is requirement of your program. So here I have give a generalized syntax, if condition then colon, then inside that if block you can again write if else or simple if block. Same thing you can repeat for else also, if condition and then else. Okay, so this is the concept of nested if, inside if or inside else. So this portion inside if else, this block is known as inner block, and this one if condition and this else is considered as outer block. So let us check how it will be implemented. So here if, okay, let me take another variable, c is equal to integer, then input enter third number. Okay, Now this simple if else is not required here. Now you can use this program here, just change the title nested if. So what you can do, first check the condition, if A is greater than B colon enter. Then if A is greater than B, then you need to make sure A is greater than C also. So here you can write inside if block, if A is greater than C, then you can surely write like this, print A is maximum. A is maximum. Okay, else if A is not maximum, then obviously only one choice we have left with, which is C. So C is maximum. Okay, so this is about only if. So from this block of statement, I can be sure that either A is maximum or either C will be maximum, because here what I have initially write, if A is greater than B. So if A is greater than B, then only it will go inside this block and check if A is greater than C also. Because what is the logic for finding the maximum number out of three number is, take any one variable and compare this variable with remaining two. If remaining two will also greater than this one, then A can be the lowest one. But if remaining two variable is smaller than this one, then you can surely say that A is maximum. So this is how the logic work for finding maximum number out of three. So same logic I have applied here. First I have checked if A is greater than B, yes. Then I have checked A is greater than C, yes. Then A is maximum, otherwise C is maximum. Now what about the remaining two variable? So that you can write inside this block, else block. Now if A is greater than B, here we have checked for A and C. So now you can check here, if B is greater than C colon print, obviously B is maximum. Else if B is not maximum, then remaining C is maximum. Okay, understand the logic. Here we have sure about the A, and here we just have to check about B and C. So let us try this, save the program, then run it. Enter the first number 12, second number 23, third number 10. So here see the output, B is maximum. Okay, so 23 is maximum. Now whenever you perform this kind of, or you make this kind of program, always check for all the possibilities. Don't take a judgment by only one output. Just check this for all the remaining variable also. So here what I will do, I will make A greater. So yes, for A this program is also true, for B it is obviously giving me the output. Now I will check for C also, 12 13 and let's say 15. So here you can see C is maximum. That means now my logic is correct. So every time you do a program or you create a program by your own, check all the possibilities in output, and yes, whether your output is true or not, after that you can only decide, yes, my logic is true. So this is about nested if. Now last one, which is ladder if else, also consider as elif in Python. So the syntax for this is, first if keyword, then give condition, then colon, write down some code for this, then elif, write down the condition, colon, some code, Now here you can write n number of elif statement. No restriction is there. And lastly, close it with else block. So this is how ladder if else work. Now let us go to programming. Same program we'll do with ladder if else also. I will show you how. So here ladder if, or you can say elif. Okay, so first give if condition. If A is greater than B, use AND operator here, and A is greater than C. If this condition is satisfied, then you can say print A is maximum. Because here what I have done, in nested if I have checked this condition separately, A greater than B, A greater than C. But in ladder if else, I can do that with the help of AND operator. So here you can use AND operator and check both of these conditions simultaneously with the help of AND operator. Now next you can write elif statement and take any one remaining variable, which is B or C, whatever. So I have taken B. B is greater than C and B is greater than A. Then colon. If this condition is true, then you can write here B is maximum. Now if you have checked for A, checked for B, so now remaining is obviously maximum. So you can, you no need to check the condition for C, you can directly write here C is maximum. Okay, so here only one elif is required. So let us check the program. Okay, let me clear the screen. Then run this again. Okay, so first number, then 13 and 14. So C is maximum. Yes, it is correct. Now check for A and B also. So suppose 34, 12 and 13. A is maximum. Yes, correct for A also. Now remaining B. So 12, 34 and 10. So B is maximum. That means for all the variable it is giving me correct output. That means my logic is correct. So this is all about if, else if, nested if and ladder if. Thank you so much for watching the whole video. If you have any doubt, you can contact me via my mail ID or you can write down in comment section. If you like the video, please like, share and subscribe and share with your friends. Thank you so much. We'll meet you in next session. Thank you.